one thing that's great about BYU athletics, the athletic program is solid as a whole. Yes. It's not just football and hoops. I love that women's soccer is ranked 17th right now, 10-game win streak. And that leads us to women's volleyball. Head coach Shawn Olmstead now joins us. 12th in the country, just 3 losses on the year, 17-3. Things are going well for you guys.
Yeah, I can't complain. We're happy with where we're at. We're excited.
I want to describe to the radio listeners what you're wearing right now. what does your shirt say?
I'm supporting El Clasico, so this is Barcelona. I've got to support my Argentina compadres, Messi, and some of those guys. Mm-hmm. They're playing, and I think the Clasico's this weekend.
Did you go on your mission there?
I did. Nice. I did, and so I've been back quite a few times actually since, and I love it, and if I can watch, I'll sit down and watch soccer maybe more than any other sport.
Wow.
So,
and then you've got an orange hat.
Peter might not like it, but I'm supporting the Deer Hunters right now. You know, it's almost over.
They need support.
The little kids out there, a lifetime memory right there. And so I just try to keep it real for you guys. And I brought you guys some gear. But it has to be in a nice color, you know. So
pink.
Yeah. We had some larges I thought would fit you guys.
Can I take one of these?
Yeah. But, Spencer, you're a little bit. Spencer's left out. I'm going to have to hook
Spencer's gone.
But, you're a little stronger than Spencer, so I wasn't planning on that. Hey. So you can work out in that. Yes. Maybe cut the sleeves off.
You know what? Normally when we get gifts from guests, I pass it on because I'm the third guy. But this right here,
I'm going to give this.
We know you do.
I'm going to give this to my grandma. I give a shout out to my grandma.
Okay,
she's a breast cancer survivor.
Awesome.
So.
Oh,
grandma,
there you go.
Love you. This shirt's for you.
Wonderful.
Thanks. I appreciate it. Sorry, Spencer.
Before we get to more important topics, less important topics maybe. When did you start liking neon? Because you're wearing pink, you got orange.
Did you see my shoes? My shoes are flower. They've got flower pattern. Yes. I mean, you got to zoom in
on
those.
Green, neon green,
but it's
and
got
orange.
Flower pattern on them. So they're impressive. Very impressive.
You did not disappoint.
No. Those are big time right there.
Interviewing some of your players, we were kind of joking and clowning around, and I'm like, do you guys ever clown on him or anything like that? You know, with his neon backpack and stuff. Man. Swag goo right here, man.
Swag daddy's got nothing
swag,
on this, right?
Nothing. Right? Nothing. You're like right here, Coach. You're like right here, and Jamal's like right there.
Yeah,
you texted a picture to Spencer and I one time of your closet
shoes. Tell me you don't have that on Sports Nation.
That was awesome. We haven't had it on yet. Okay. We needed to pull that up.
I don't know where it started. It just was one day, one thing, and from there, the girls just made a joke out of it, and I can't tell you, I kid you not, I can't tell you how many days I come home from work where my wife didn't see me leave. Eve, and I walk in the door and she goes, "You really wore that to work today?" And I just said, "I don't know. I didn't even think twice about it." So obviously, I didn't think twice about
it. Man problems.
Yeah, there you go.
Honey, get off my swag, honey. That's what you got to say to her.
Yeah.
Your team has swag. You guys are killing it right now. I know last Friday, lost at San Diego in 5, but other than that, you've won 12 of 13. What are you guys doing right?
Yeah, no, the girls, it's all about the kids. You know, I'm kind of a bystander and just excited to be there. And, you know, we put some things together, but the girls, we just got an outstanding group of girls that have been able to focus on every single match one at a time. And there's a lot of experience there with, you know, Jennifer Hampson, Alexa Gray, Tamara Noble. There's just a solid group of kids with experience. And we're talking football and we're talking injuries. People that have not been in athletics don't understand the value of experience.
Yeah.
And you look at when I played, you know, we lost a national championship my junior year in 5 sets.
2003.
We come back and we returned all this experience. Almost every guy in that lineup was back. We go into 5 sets. We're not rattled at all. We go win the national championship in 5 sets. The experience is so crucial and so valuable.
I'm really happy you said that for the football fans out there. To really show the difference with experience and how much it really helps you. And I think something too. I mean, you guys fall to San Diego, and mm-hmm. you guys come back home. You give them some extra time off, right?
Yeah.
And with that experience, with that leadership, they bounce back.
Yeah.
Well, when you have guys like you look at the football situation, right? And how guys are, you know, you lose. Well, how do you bounce back? And then you know that lack of maturity mm-hmm. or experience, you can kind of keep on going the wrong direction.
Yeah, you know, I'm standing up for my guy Bronco right now because a lot of people rip on him for, you don't use your – I mean, I see it all, and people are just – they don't understand. So we got back on Saturday. We didn't play Saturday. I gave him Saturday, Sunday, and Monday off, and it was a perfect time for us. Then we come home, and we play LMU, who, if you follow
right
volleyball –
right outside the top 25.
Just fell out of the top 25 last week. They'd been in it pretty much all year.
Good team.
And a very good team, and we needed to just regroup. Yep. Just, hey, things are fine. We got after it Tuesday, Wednesday in prep for this match, and the girls responded exactly as I figured they would and exactly as we needed them to.
How tough is that as a coach? I mean, I know things are going great as far as, you know, the win streak, but then you lose, and you're like, everybody's running sprints. Everybody. We may have Sunday practice, maybe.
It's amazing. It's amazing to me. No, you're exactly right. It's amazing to me how good life can be, and then in a moment where we barely lost too, yeah, on the road to San Diego in a 5-set match. All of a sudden, I feel like my world's over. And what did I do? Like, why am I coaching, honey? What am I doing? We've got to reevaluate everything. We got, yeah, you know, and you've got to just stay focused. And I think, you know, that's what we've been able to do. And I have a great staff around me and some, just like I said, some great mature players, yeah, that are able to just go, yo, you know, the world isn't over.
Right.
You're going to lose matches. And very rarely, you know, maybe in football where they don't play as many, but when you've got these sports where you play a lot of contests,
yep, you'll lose.
Basketball, you're going to lose, yeah, sometime here or there, and that's okay. Yep. That's fine.
You mentioned that you beat LMU. The second set, I had to do a double take on that. It's like 25-9.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. Mm-hmm. And one thing that sticks out to me as I'm getting ready to jump in and call Saturday's women's, mm-hmm, volleyball match, excited about that, you're the number one blocking team in the country, and, yeah, you have the number one blocker, Whitney Young.
Yeah.
Why are you guys so effective at the net?
You know, one, I think our girls pay really, really close attention to what we prepare them for. And I've never, ever gone into a match and felt as the match started like, oh, man, we weren't prepared for what's coming. So the girls know what's coming. They're waiting for it, and they see it, and they're reacting accordingly. And I think that's really been helpful. Then we've got some kids. Whitney Young's lightning fast.
Number one in the country.
It helps Jen Hansen to be 6'7". Alexa Gray is as physical as all can be. I mean, so we've got some great athletes, but they're doing the right things. They're watching the right things and seeing the other side unfold in front of them and then reacting accordingly.
Did you take McGowan-isms of blocking principles and apply that to your coaching? Because, yeah, BYU is known for being a great blocking men's team.
Yeah, I was with Carl, a couple hours just this week in the film room. So Carl's helping tremendously with us. He was there at the match last night, and he's a very, very big influence in my life and everything I've done, and we try to adapt the same thing. We're starting in a bunch read. We're helping on the quick, and that helps, too, in women's volleyball. In the middle, a lot of women's players don't see two blockers up in front of them. Right. They're used to just one blocker there, and so we're helping. So now there's more hands in front of them, so all those things help.
One of McGowan's assistant coaches during the run of the late 90s and 2000s is Pepperdine's head coach now. Troy Tanner. What kind of relationship do you have with Troy?
Yeah, Troy was my coach for the 3 years that I was here with Carl. And when Carl retired, Troy left and started a very, very successful club in Southern California. And he's done, now taken over his alma mater. So he's a BYU guy as a coach.
But he got a graduate degree at BYU.
At BYU, yeah. And exactly. And
It all starts here.
Hopefully, yeah, it ends tomorrow for him. But no, Troy. Troy and I have a great relationship. I think very, very highly of Troy. He always was great to me, and I joke with his kids. I used to, when I was a redshirt, Troy would go on the road, and his wife would work, and he'd have me babysit his kids because I wasn't traveling.
Nice.
So hey, here's the return missionary. He knows me from my dad from even longer back, you know, when he was a player. I used to go watch Troy. So he's known, wow, me, and I'd go babysit his kids. So I have a great relationship with Troy.
That's a
great story.
That's, yeah, so smart.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Good luck tomorrow, 3 Eastern time, BYU and Pepperdine live on BYU TV and BYU Radio. And thanks for the shirt.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks for everything you guys do. Thank you.
Always keeping it real. Shawn, yep, Olmstead. No one dresses like Shawn Olmstead.
No, winner.
I didn't say whether it was good or bad. No one dresses
good
like Shawn Olmstead.
There we go.
Approved.